Hello guys, welcome to Buddy Developers once again, and in this video we will see the different default geodirectory page templates. So let's start. So inside geodirectory settings and in pages, so here you will find all the default page templates available in geodirectory. Each one have its own importance, so we will check them in detail. So location page is basically the master page, or you can say the base page of all the locations. So suppose in your website you have 10, 20, thousands of different locations, cities, states, countries. You don't have to worry about managing the layout of different cities, different locations in your website. You can just go to your location page, set up the sort code there, and that sort code will be applied for all the locations that are available in your website dynamically. The second page template is add listing page, from where your user can add a listing in your website. So if you want any changes on this page, any notice messages, anything you want to add here, you can better go to this setting and click on edit page, and whatever you will write here on this page template will be reflected on your add listing page template. The next template in row is search page template. So if you want to make any changes on the geodirectory search page, anything, maybe you want to change the layout of this page or add any content, you can just go to this setting and click on edit page. And over this search page template, you can change, make the changes, and that changes will be reflected on the search page of geodirectory. So you can, so for example, I'm just changing this page layout to full width. So I refresh the page and here you can see the search page turned to a full width page. The next page template is terms and condition page. So you can set the terms and condition related to your listing site here on this page. Then we have these three page templates that are very important, and I'm sure most of the GD users wants to customize them. So detail page is basically to set the layout of your listing detail page. For example, this is the listing detail page, and if you want to change the layout of this page, then you can just go to the setting and click on the edit page of GD detail page template, and here basically whatever you will add will get reflected to your listing detail page. The most common sort code used on this page is single tab to show the tab layout, single navigation previous and next, and then post image shortcode to show the image, post thumbnail image of your listing, and you can also show the categories that you are post in through this single taxonomy shortcode. And GD notification is basically to notify something related. And then we have the archive page template. So if you want to set the layout of any of your archive page, for example, the main business page, or you can see the archive page of your CPT, if you want to change the layout of this page, or maybe you want to change the layout of the category page, then you can just go to this setting again and just edit the GD archive page template by clicking on this edit page. And here basically you can set the layout for your archive page. And you may be seeing these tabs here, this specific listing specific tabs. So these tabs have their own own definition, like you can see an image here, and then category, and then title, and then contain, and then you have some rating icon or favorite icon, you have some business hour listed here. So in order to set the layout of individual item, you have a template called GD archive item page template. So you can basically click on edit and you can set the layout of your archive item page here. So these all templates are basically the required and very important to geodirectory. So if any case you accidentally deleted them, then you can just go to this geodirectory status and then in the tool, and here you can see a setting, create default geodirectory pages. You can just run it and it will create those deleted pages for you. So in upcoming videos of this video series, we will see that how you can customize the layout of these pages through Elementor, through DB Builder, or through Gutenberg editor of WordPress. So that's it for today. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe the channel for more such informative videos related to GeoDirectory and related to WordPress. And if you have any query, you can just mention me in the comment. I reply to all the comments. So thanks. See you in the next video.